In the year 2025, half of the jobs that your company has today will no longer exist. Now, that's one of those bold, let me get your attention type statements. To be honest, I think it's more 2035 we're talking about. But either way, whether it takes 10 years or 20 years to get there, we are going to, in the next decade or two, we are going to automate a remarkable number of jobs. Automation is going to come through robotics and intelligent robotics, but it's mainly going to come through a word that is going to define our lives over the next 20 years, and that is algorithms. Algorithms are intelligent software solutions that integrate hardware and software and systems and begin to process thinking, begin to be able to make decisions. Initially simple decisions, but increasingly complex decisions. And it'll all be online and automated. So GPs out of the system within 10 years. I'm convinced of that. We won't go to GPs. We will be self-diagnosing, please put the phone against your chest. Let's hear your, breathe in. And the same will be true with lawyers, with certain engineers, with accountants, with actuaries. So what do we do? Well, the second major trend is we all just stop going full-time and we go part-time. So another fact from the future. By 2025, 25% of the people who work in your office will be freelancers. So half of the people are not going to be there at all, and another 25% are only going to be there on demand. So this is, I think, the phrase that we're going to get used to, the on-demand economy, that you only get the skills that you need when you need them, and only for when you need them. Now, of course, the industry that knows how to do this is Hollywood. For 100 years, Hollywood has brought together massive talent and a variety of talent, everything from the top quality producer right down to the assistant grip. Whatever the assistant grip does. And you put them all together, and the only thing that is required is two things. One, you have to put their name in the credits at the end of the project, that's the film, and you have to pay them. And other than that, they are an on-demand industry. So, freelancers is not just, outsourcing security at the front desk. This is outsourcing any job that you know. And a quarter of the people who work in your company 10 years from today are going to be like this. We've got to prepare people for this as a career, surely. The third major trend is that you have a supercomputer in your pocket. Less than an arm's length away from you at all times these days is the most powerful handheld computing devices we have ever created. And 10 years from now, we're gonna look back on these devices we've got today and say, good grief, how did we ever survive? I mean, we'll look back on these things and think how rubbish they were. Now we know this, so I won't say more about that. What I do want to say is that it isn't just for the rich. That was an iPhone 6 Plus. That's an expensive piece of machinery sitting in my pocket. So if you've got money, it's cool. You can be part of this smart device planet. But if you don't, you're also fine, because there are Chinese cell phone manufacturers that are producing cell phones now for 500 Rand. It's not 500 Rand a month until you die. That's an iPhone. It's 500 Rand straight out. And you've got these fully functioning smartphones based on the Android system, 2 gigabytes of memory, 2 megapixel cameras, or $500. And then, of course, we get free Wi-Fi. Elon Musk, who we know is a good old Pretoria boy, South African, he's working with Google, Facebook, and his own companies to bring free Wi-Fi to flood Africa. So if we can give people free Wi-Fi, right, if we can give them free cloud storage, and we can give them a 500 Rand smartphone, everybody gets to play. Everybody enters the digital age. So my final point is this. If we're heading towards talking about education, then if we're putting smart devices into everybody's hands, if we're freelancing, if we're opening up the economy and we're automating everything, well, then it must be obvious that content is free. And the universities of the world have worked this out already. MOOCs, massive open online courses. The world's best universities are putting their best courses online for free. So why does your HR department exist? Why do they spend all the time that they spend to devise a magnificent leadership program for you, and then you can go and do Harvard MBA for free online? Because you can. What does GIBS do next? What do people like me, this is what I do for a living, what do we do next? And we've got to work this out. But that's just my example from my industry. I think the thing that is going to change everything is that a lot of what your companies do is going to have to be offered for free.